Welcome back to part two of Call Unhooked. And as I was saying about the Killers Hi-Fi thing, I can't wait until that's finally revealed, because that has been annoying me for months on end. And talking about the SMF SmackDown Extra, that was commentated by Dr. Pizza, who I think is a really, really, really good commentator. I think he's just hilarious, you know. I wouldn't actually mind him commentating for XWE on a regular basis. I mean, every once in a while, you know, it would be something different, I suppose, but I think that's a good wee bit down the line. Because I know he was looking for a commentating jobs, but I think maybe XWE isn't big enough yet, but you never know, could happen, but I just think he's a hilarious commentator, you know. That's just me. I know a lot of people don't like him, but that's just me. But anyway, I'm moving on now again, and as you can see there, it's a screenshot of Survivor Shaw 2009. And this is taken from the SMF forums, I believe. I know Super Dingles posted that about 2 weeks ago, and as you can see there, there's a lot of like weird things. You know, you see the same old DDT through a table, and apparently the Inferno match, as you can see there, is going to be brought into it. Judging from that, the graphics don't look to have improved. Maybe it looks like Randy Orton's sort of changed a wee bit. And, you know, the move animations look relatively the same, like that sidewalk slam Undertaker's doing, the DDT, the barrier drop thing, and I don't think it'll be that much of an improvement from last year, apart from the creative finisher. That's about all. See, even the RKO crowd signs the fucking same. Jesus, THQ, get your finger out your ass and create a game for once in your life. But as you can see there in the bottom right corner, I don't know if you can see it, it says anyway that Game Master hates the same old gameplay. And then again, as you can see here, is the fantastic cover of WWE SmackDown vs. Raw 2009. The thing I hate there is you can barely see that featuring ECW. I know ECW sort of sucks ass, but you know, as part of WWE, and it's a bit small. Or that cover to me is just cheapish, you know. There's really nothing to do. It's just him looking like an ugly fucker, and Shawn Michaels like, yes, I'm coming for you. It's like they didn't really spend that much time on it as such. I know last year's was kind of fucking weird, and 06's was shit too, but the original Survivor Shaw was good with Vince McMahon with the two with the red and blue eye. That was good. But anyway, this leaves Survivor Shaw 2009 now, 'cause it's probably gonna suck ass anyway. And now I'll tell you about Revelation. It's gonna be coming inside, I think, about a week or so, roughly. I think maybe not a week or so, maybe. I'd say it could be here probably by, not this Saturday, but sometime next week. I don't know when though, I have absolutely no idea when, but hopefully it should be sometime next week, hopefully. If I can get the time to get it saved and then upload it, if I can get the time to do that, then it's alright. But apart from that, I don't know when it could be. It won't be like delayed for too long if it is, but maybe be delayed by a week or something, but it won't be delayed anymore than that. And as you know, Undertaker's taking on Abyss in the final. In the main event, sorry, fucking final, what the hell. The final main event thing of it, because there's basically like two main events in it, Kurt Angle and Rock and Undertaker and Abyss. And that's in the Hell in a Cell for the XWE Championship. And I know all the eyes are going to be on Revelation, because I know Zach from ICCW said he'd watch it. And I hope he's not disappointed, because that's my main goal when he said that, was to impress him, as I'm sure a lot of people's would be. So Zach, if you're watching this here, that's my goal for Revelation, to impress you. Okay, if I can manage to do that, then I've succeeded. I think I've succeeded already after one CPV, but no. From my judging of what I've recorded on that there, of what I think of it, in my opinion, it should be good. And I'm just gonna point out that I know a lot of people say about the WWE guys in it, and I know, Zach, you even said about that there, and I know there's WWE guys in it, and you said about, especially when they're themselves, you can expect a few gimmick changes in the coming weeks of XWE, and I'm going to get rid of a few of the actual WWE guys in it, because I find it sort of hard to work with them and, you know, work on their character, because I don't want them to be like what they are in WWE. So I don't, if I was going to do it, I'd change it, which I am planning on doing. Okay, so Revelation's done, SMF's done, ICCW, okay. Next thing I was going to talk about is some of the colleagues I've sort of spotted the past few while. I know you've got the usual SCAW, EWF, DWA, SMF, ICCW, no longer, but so we'll leave ICCW out of that. You've got those other four, and basically every time you talk about colleagues, they're the four that are mostly mentioned. You know, you don't really hear of many other leagues, and I know there's tons out there, there's thousands of them, especially in the Call Underground, which I don't regularly visit, but I know there's a lot there. You've got your serious ones, and you've got your comedy ones. And I know a lot of people prefer the comedy type leagues, and so do I prefer the comedy league. Because I know XWE is a comedy league, or well, trying to be, I suppose. But comedy leagues are better, well, not maybe not better, but I prefer them to the serious ones. The serious ones are good, because the wrestling is awesome. Like, take NGW, for example. The wrestling in that is absolutely incredible, I have to say. But SMF is a different type of colleague. You know, it's funny, it's random, and, you know, it's just something you can just sit down and watch. And all this recently, people have been too serial about, you know, oh, you said nigger too many times, you know. I'm just so sick and tired of hearing that. Every time you go on the SMF forums or something, somebody's fucking went serial, someone's went mad, you know. It's just, it's never ending. And it seems to be the past wee while that this has just started happening, because whenever I started watching SMF about early 2007, like maybe February, there was no mention of Syria, you know, everybody just laughed and took it as it was. But now, since people are like botching in leagues, people's trying to, you know, going serial, and oh my god, you just hear it all the time. But anyway, as I said, it was about a couple of colleagues, and there's one in particular that I've been watching the past few while, and it's called ALW. All Legends Wrestling, I think it stands for. And they've got the first TPV coming up next couple of weeks called Curtain Call. So you should check that out. The league is good itself. You know, it features some wrestlers that are dead, some that have retired, some that do wrestle now, I think. Because it's got Bret Hart, it's got Owen Hart, it's got The Rock, Stone Cold. He also got Ric Flair. It's got the Outsiders, Nash and Hall. It's got the Legion of Doom. It's got Hulk Hogan. Fuck me, it's even got Brock Lesnar as well. So, you know, it's got a couple of recent ones, it's got a couple of old ones. It's even got Eddie Guerrero in his old persona, like, it's nearly like his ECW persona. And I have to say, all knower of WWE TNA1, I think your username is, or just call you ALW owner, and say your cause are absolutely awesome. Your Eddie Guerrero one in particular is pretty amazing, and I want to thank you for doing that. XWE predictions video, it's the first one I think anybody done. Or wait, sorry, that guy Crazy Dude 3215, I think his username is, done one as well. So thank you for making one, William. And if you ever go on Call Underground, you can see by the banners at the top, there's a couple of leagues advertised, and I suppose it might be worth checking them out, because you never know what you can see or what they'll be like. But Colin O'Brien, I know a lot of the people stay away from there, sort of, because it's a bit rather weird, I know. But anyway, I suppose we're getting to the end of this video because time's going to run out. I only want to do like a two-parter anyway, so thanks for watching this here, and I suppose you maybe will expect one next week at some stage. I don't know, you might not, but anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Caught Underhook and Revelation.